Her eyes sparkled as she asked the question. She tried to hide it, but I recognized that look. I knew it from a mile away. She did that thing she always does. She was the only one blessed with the ability to ask me a life-changing question in the most nonchalant, offhanded way possible. Somehow she always managed to accent it with her crooked little smile. Her smile had an infectious way of spreading to me. She explained, "I'm killing myself at school because I think it's going to be worth it. You know, if we move in together." She could change the trajectory of my entire life just by adding those five tiny words. If we move in together. Actually, I just realized it wasn't even a question. She was good. Her and that crooked little smile knew I wasn't going anywhere. I smiled back. Of course I wanted to live with her. It was Robin. She was the love of my life, my driving force. She knew me better than I knew myself. She could motivate me, inspire me, and she knew when to take control. Like whenever we were underneath my Billy Joel poster. So I kissed her. Instantly, I knew we would remember this moment for the rest of our lives. The kiss was perfect. She was standing there, right off the edge of the curb, eyes gleaming up at me, a smile flirting across her lips. And there I was, cheesing in unbelief like some doofus and still on the sidewalk. I was in awe that a creature this alluring desired a future with me. She was so close. Her chest barely pressed against mine as she tiptoed up to me. Even though we were out in public, she was all I could see. It's weird how love can transform a 5'3" woman into the largest thing in my entire world. I mean, we might as well have been in the middle of the street. Cars were commuting, people walking, horns, sirens, you name it. But when I'm with her, the whole world seems to just tear away until it's just Robin. At that moment, those sparkling brown eyes devoured my goofy grin. She joked about laying pipe at my dad's place under that Billy Joel poster, and I just couldn't stop myself. I leaned in and I kissed her. I must say it was one of my better kisses. My nose didn't stab her in the eye. Our teeth didn't collide. Our lips just fit together. Like the sun caressing the horizon for the first time. Fireworks. The perfect kiss, the perfect moment. I knew my life was about to change. She was my next chapter. I pulled away with my eyes still closed, savoring the softness of her lips, and a comeback sprung to mind. Don't you ever besmirch Billy Joel. My brain glitched. It had to be some type of glitch because she disappeared. She was there, not even one word ago. Since that time, less than a fraction of a second had passed, but she was gone. I could still feel her, but she wasn't there. This didn't make any sense. Something wet landed on my cheek. I blinked. Was it rain? More of it was coming. Red droplets landed on my nose and on my mouth. The taste told me that it was blood. Everything was happening so quickly and my mind raced to keep up. Time froze as my senses attempted to absorb the surroundings. Out of the corner of my eye, I noticed something white spiraling in the air. It looked like bone. Whatever it was floating amidst a huge body of burgundy liquid. All at once, time restarted. A tsunami of blood splashed onto the ground, a jawbone crashed against the concrete, a spinal cord splattered in the pool. Bubbles and teeth floated through the Red Sea. I just stood there, in the wake of this bloody, bony, burgundy graveyard, until I heard someone speak. "I can't stop, I can't stop, I can't stop." I looked up and there he was, A-Train, my favorite superhero, the speedster, the blur in blue, except today, he was covered in red. Almost as soon as I recognized him, he was gone, bloody footprints trailing off as far as the eye could see. He left me standing there, on the sidewalk, in a literal bloodbath. And then it all clicked. This was Robin. She was plastered all over the street. A-Train ran so fast that he ran right through Robin. Jaw, spine, intestines, blood, skull. Robin was all there, just inside out. The only things missing were her arms. I looked down and I still had her hands in mine. Robin. Hey guys, thanks for watching. This is a brand new channel, and this was a production of one of my favorite scenes from the Amazon series, The Boys. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, like the video. The next performance will be a recreation of a scene from Marvel's WandaVision, so click the subscribe button. Can you think of a better scene? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to cultivate a community with a real passion for cinema and art, so share this with your friends. I'm looking forward to hearing back from you. Peace.